Hello everyone, my name is Shambhavi. Hope you all are doing well. So today in the SQL, we are going to study out a new topic, and just let me quickly introduce you to that particular topic. So the one which we are going to do today is the aggregate. We have aggregate functions, in SQL. Okay, this is what we are going to learn today. In the SQL, fine. So what I would do is that I would just quickly take out a new color so that it doesn't make out too much differentiation while writing out the things. And yeah, let's get started up. So first, let's understand about that. What are aggregate functions actually? Okay. So I go here that in a database, in database management, in database management system, in database management, and An aggregate function is a function, in database management, an aggregate function is a function where the values, where the values of multiple rows are grouped together, where the values of multiple rows are grouped together as input. And let me just get down here, get out some space. So in database management, an aggregate function is a function where the values of multiple rows are grouped together as input on certain criteria to form a single value of more significant meaning. Here goes the meaning, fine. This is what we meant by aggregate function is in SQL, basically that in the database management system, in the database management, an aggregate function is a function where the values of multiple rows are grouped together as input on certain criteria to form a single value of more significant meaning, right? So yes, this is what first of all we meant from aggregate functions in SQL, fine. After that, what are the different aggregate functions which we have here in the SQL? So let me just go down, fine, right here, and fine. Now I would term out here that the various aggregate functions. Number one, we go with the count function. So number one, we go with the count. Okay. Number two, we go with the function, that's the sum. Okay. Number three, we go with the average, AVG. Fine. Number four, we go with the min function. And at last, we are having the function, that's the max. So here we go with the max. Fine. So here we have these five aggregate functions that are count, sum, average, min, and max. Fine. These are the aggregate functions which we have in the SQL. Now what I'll be doing is that I would be quickly making out a quick data right here, and according to that only we'll be proceeding on seeing on all of these functions, that how they work and what are the functioning of those. So here goes my table. Now I just want out some different rows as well here. So let's say one is for the ID. Then we are having this for the name, and then we have it for the salary. Right here. Right, and I'll just make out one single line as well that will represent out the column name. So here we go with the column name. Fine. So I'll be setting up some values onto this particular data. First one, as I mentioned, that would be my ID. Second one would be my name and third one will be my salary. Fine, so ID goes from 1 up to 6. So here goes 1, 2, we have 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, name goes like A, B, C, D, E and then we go here as F. Okay, let's say salaries we are having, let's say 80, 90, 70, let's say we have 50, let's say that's 40 and here we have let's say null. Okay, so this is what one of my tables I just quickly made out here as an example. Now I'll be moving forward with each and every aggregate function that we have studied out. So the very first one that I am having right here is the count function. Okay, the very first function which we are having here is basically the count function. Now what happens here, if I write out count and I put on an asterisk, count asterisk, what does it returns to me as an output? Okay, so completely it returns total, it returns total number of, it returns total number of records. Okay, whenever I am writing count and after that I am putting out an asterisk, so it means that it is going to return out the total number of records. Fine, now what are the total number of records which we are, let's say here I go, so in the total number of records I have total 6 records here, right? So if I just run out this particular query, so in that case I would be getting out the result as 6, that is 6. Fine, so this is what this count asterisk returns me. Now next, if I just go and write out here count and if I write out here in the bracket instead of asterisk, I want now the salary only. Okay, so what it will return, it will return number of return number of non-null values over the column salary. So what it is going to give me as an output, it is going to return me the number of non-null values over the column salary. So if I just go on to the column that is salary, so in total I have 5 non-null values, right? So I'll be getting out an answer as that is 5. Okay, so why 5? I already explained out, because in that particular case it is going to return me out the non-null values over the column that is the salary which I mentioned. Fine, next command what I have is, okay, with the count function, if I just write out here as distinct salary, count distinct salary, count distinct salary. Okay, now into that particular case what could I return out? I could return number of distinct values, distinct non-null values over the column salary, that is 4. Okay, so count basically returns out the number of distinct non-null values over the column salary, that is total 4. So if I go onto the salary column, here I go onto the salary one. So when I'm just checking out, so how am I having? Okay, all the 5 values which I'm having that are distinct. In this case, instead of 4, I'll be getting out the answer as 5. Because I have none of the values which are basically non-distinct to each, right? Each and every values are unique onto my particular data which I am having, right? So in that particular case, that's the reason that why I am getting out the final output here as 5. So if I wrote out count distinct salary, so it is going to return me out the number of distinct non-null values over the column that is salary. Fine. So let's take out a quick revision regarding the aggregate functions in SQL. So in database management, an aggregate function is a function where the values of multiple rows are grouped together as input on certain criteria to form out a single value of more significant meaning. Okay, so in database management, aggregate function is a kind of a function where the values of multiple rows are grouped together as input on certain criteria to form out a single value of more significant meaning. Fine. The aggregate functions which you are having are count, sum, average, min, and max. So this was the data that we had made out, and that we need to go through. Fine. Okay, one second. Right here. Then we saw regarding out the count function, that what is there in the count function. So in if that we feed it just write out count asterisk, it means that it is going to return out the total number of records which you are having, right? If I wrote about count salary, so it is going to return you out the number of non-null values over the column, that is salary. And if I write out count distinct salary, so it returns out the number of distinct non-null values over the column salary, that is 5, right? So hope I am very much clear with this particular thing in regards of these all of the things which I have mentioned for you regarding the count and the aggregate functions. So the functions which we are left with, that we are going to see in the next video. So this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and take care.